going to look at two implementation of list, two important implementations of list. One is arrays and one is using linked list. So, first let us look at the implementation of lists using arrays. Now, before we go into that, we have to know what an array is. Now, array is usually associated with a pair of values, an index and a value, and it is a sequence of indexed items. For example, when I say the first element, it is the index is 1 and then the element is also fixed as 5 or something like that. If I say 10, A 10, it means that the 10th index is 10 and the element, whatever is the value of the element there, will come out. So, associated with each index there is a value. And normally an important constraint of arrays is that the length of the array has to be fixed before the array is created, and it is implemented using consecutive memory. Now, one important thing that we have to know is that when we represent a list using arrays, the list is logically continuous as well as physically continuous. In other words, the elements of the array are stored in consecutive memory locations. Now, when an array is created, a sequence of that means, in other words, when an array is created, a consecutive memory blocks is allocated dynamically to store the value of the elements of the array. So, if you take an example, let us assume that the array consists of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. You will see that here we are assuming that two address locations are used to represent one element of the array. So, 1, 2, 2, 8 contains 0, 1, 2, 3, 0 contains 1, and the index will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the contiguous memory locations that are allocated. And normally when you talk about an array, the indices of the array range from a lower bound, normally 0 in most programming languages, through to a higher bound, which is n minus 1, which means that you can represent n elements using this particular array. And any item of the array can be accessed directly by just giving its index. So, when you say A1, you can access the first element. When you say A5, you can access the fifth element. And the time complexity of accessing an element is 0 of the order of 1, which means even if it is a 1000 element array, if you say A1000, you can access directly the 1000th element. So, operations that you do are create, initialize, length. Length is to find the number of elements in the array, and insertion and deletion. So, given an array like A left to right, you can insert a value at a particular location. If necessary, we will have to shift the elements. Similar, this insertion and deletion is the most time consuming and inefficient operations when you represent a list using an array. Now, search on the other hand is the most efficient operation that you do when you represent the list using an array. List is finding any particular element from the array, from the list represented using an array. So, arrays is a basic data structure, and it can store any type of element. It can be an integer array, it can be a character array, it can be a structure, an array consisting of nodes, which is a structure. An important application of arrays is the representation of a polynomial. The polynomial consists of coefficients and exponents, and the degree of the polynomial is the largest exponent. So, this particular polynomial you can represent using an array. For example, you will have 3 as one data element and 20 as another data element, plus 2 as another, 5 as another, and so on. Another representation of a list. Now, we are, please remember, we are still talking about lists and how to implement the list. The first type we saw was an array. The second type we are going to look at is a linked list. Now, if you look here, this is a typical representation of a list which is represented using a linked list. Now, you see that bat, cat, sat and vat is a list, and logically they are next to each other or sequential. But when you use a linked list to represent a list, the memory or the physically they are not adjacent to each other, they are only logically adjacent to each other. For example, bat can be stored at 1000th location, cat can be stored at the 200th location, for example, sat at 600 and vat at 2000. In spite of that, because of this link between this link points to the address of the next element, and because of this they become logically adjacent to each other, though they are physically not adjacent to each other. So, a linked list is a chain of elements, and now every node in the linked list has got two parts, at least two parts. One is the data and the other is the link. So, a linked list can be represented using a P head, which is the pointer to the head of the list or the first element in the list. And if you have an empty linked list, then this P head will have a null value, and then a node, an element of the linked list, can have just one data field, which is the example given here, can have three data fields, which is the example given here, where you have name, ID and grid points or whatever. And it has always a link in the linked list we have seen up to now, it has a single link field or address field. And here we see that the node is represented as a structure, name, address and phone, and again you have a link field. There are many ways in which linked lists can be represented. In the one that we are going to look at, we are looking at defining the linked list using two structures. One is the head structure and one is a data node structure. This head structure need not be represented. There are other implementations which do not use a separate structure for representing the head node. We are assuming that we are using a separate structure. So you have a head structure and a data node structure. The head structure will consist of the count of the number of elements in the node and a pointer to the first node in the list. The node on the other hand consists of data and a pointer to the next element in the list. So if you represent this, the head structure consists of count, which is an integer, and head, which is a pointer, in other words an address. And here you have a data, which is a data type. Please note this data can have more than one element, it can have a structure, it can have anything, and link, which is a pointer to the next element. So these are the two structures that are used to define the type of elements in a linked list as we have represented the linked list. So this is the method in which you represent this. This is just a representation of what we have seen previously. Now if you look here, this is a typical linked list which has been created using the structures given here. So here you have the head which points to the first node in the list, and the count gives the number of elements in the list, which is 2, and this is a head node. These are data nodes, and this consists of the data and a pointer to the next node, and this is a data and a pointer to the next node. This will be null if this is the last node in the linked list. This is a representation of the head and count, and this is the representation of if it is a name. Here the previous one we have put it as data. If it is a name list, you will have the same structure, except that the data will be represented by a character. And here you have person. You can also represent it using a person, which is a data pointer to a data, and a node, which is a pointer to the link. Now we have to look at some operations that we have as far as the linked list is concerned. One is that you have to find out whether the linked list is empty, and another thing is, because we are talking about linked list, we have to allocate memory for the node, and that is done by this malloc structure. This malloc structure will take the node and will allocate a memory location for the data node when it is created. So the operations that we do on a linked list implementation of a list is same as that we do on any list. So you have to create a list, you have to add a node, you can delete a node, you can find a node, and you can traverse a list. Now please note that in the linked list representation, the addition of a node at the beginning, middle or end is slightly different, and similarly deletion at the beginning, middle or end is slightly different, because we have represented something called a head node. This is a representation of how to create a node. So you will have a pointer, and you can create the data here and have a pointer to the null. It can be represented by a null, which is does not have a pointer to the next node, or it can have a pointer to the next node. Now please note here that here is creating a two nodes list. The structure for this, it creates a linked list with two nodes. So first you are defining two nodes, first and second, and the first node you are allocating space for the first node, you are allocating space for the second node, and then what you are doing is you are assuming that this is the first node and this is the second node. So you are the second node, the link of the second node is set equal to null, and the data of the second node is set equal to 20, and the data of the first node is set equal to 10, and the data of the next is made to point to this. How do you get the address of this? This is available here when you are doing the malloc. So this is a very, it is not a generalized implementation, it is an implementation of hard code implementation of how to create a two node list. Now please note that when you have a linked list like this, the only way you can enter into this linked list or access the linked list is through this pointer or the the pointer has to have an address of the first node, then only you can access the linked list, implementation of the list. So, now let us look at how to create a list. Please note that we had said that we had a separate structure called head node, which consists of the count of the number of elements in the node and a pointer to the first node of the element. So, before you start, the count is, you do not have, it is undefined, and the head is also, there is no address pointing there. Now, I want to create a list. So, what I do is, I put list head equal to null, okay, that is, I set this equal to null, and I set the count to be equal to 0, because this is an empty list. So, after the creation operation, this is the output, that is, count has become equal to 0 and the head has been set to be null. Please note that the number of elements in the list at this point is still 0, and you have just created the head node. In other words, in the creation operation, you are just setting up the head node. So, this is the implementation of the head node. So, you have the data, and this p node is the pointer to the next element. So, you put the pointer equal to null, and you can also define something called empty. You want to check whether a list is empty, that also can be done. Now, you want to add an element to an empty list. So, before the add operation, you have already created the empty list. So, this is what you will have. This is what we saw in the last slide also. And now, you want to add this particular node, data node, into this list. This is the data. This p new is nothing but the address of this node, okay, and this is undefined as f. Now, how do you add this node to this list? This is what we have to see. So, the first step is that you set the link of this to be equal to the link of this. Now, it so happens, because it is an empty list into which you are adding, this actually will be set to null, okay. Then you have to change the count of the head node to 1, because you are adding one element, and then the next step you have to do is actually change this link to point to this. So, that is the next step. This link, which is the pointer from the head node to the new node, which is given by list dot head equal to this address, which is, we know, is p new. Okay. So, what has happened is, the link field of this has been set equal to the link field of this, which is null, and the head has been made to point to p new, and this is the state of the list, and the count has been set to 1, because now it contains one node. And this is what happens after the add operation. So, this link and then this link being set here. So, this is how we have added a new, please do not think of this as a link, this is just p new giving the address of this node. So, this is how you add one node to an empty list, okay. Now, we look at adding at the beginning of the list. This is almost similar to adding a node at the, like we did, adding one node to an empty list. It is, this is the list before you do the beginning, adding at the beginning. This is the node, data node, that you want to add to the list. Where do you want to add? We want to add it here, okay. So, this is what is the status before you do the add operation. Now, what you have to do first is, the link field of this has to be set equal to the link, the address of this. What you have done is, you have set the address of this node to be equal to, you have set the link of this node to be equal to this, and you have set the link of this node to be equal to this. Now, if you reverse the operations here, you won't get the answer, or you will end up in trouble, because I do not know the address of this. Where is the address of this available? The address of this is available only in this. Now, if I initially change this and put this equal to here, I have lost the address of this. So, you cannot do the insertion. So, you have to necessarily do it in this order. First, what you have to do, you have to set the link of this to point to this, and then change the head to point to this first node. So, now the list is like this, head node 3975, okay. So, this is how you add an element to the front of the list. So, this is just to show you that when you are doing an insertion, you are just inserting this like this, and you are not changing, you are just changing two links, while when we were doing insertion of lists using arrays, we were actually changing the index of a number of elements. So, suppose you had to add an element in an array in the fifth position, and the array consists of 1500 elements, then from the sixth position up to 1500 you have to change the index of all the elements. So, that is the costly operation, while when you are doing insertion in linked list it is much more easier. So, insertion and deletion operation in lists is easier when it is represented as linked list. Now, we are going to see the addition of a node in the middle of a list. So, before the add operation, we are assuming that the linked list is like this. It consists of two nodes, 39 and 75. P head is pointing to the first node. Now, what we want to do is we want to add an element 52 here. Okay. That is, we want the list to look like this now, like this. Now, in order to do that, you need to know the address of this node. So, that is what is put as P previous. So, now the node has changed after the addition. Now, you have three nodes. This does not change. Now, what you are doing is this P news link has to be changed, or link has to be fixed at this 75. Or the address of 75. How do you get the address of 75? The address of 75 is nothing but the link of previous. So, now you are setting P news link is nothing but P previous link. The address that you have to set here is nothing but the address that you had here. So, that is the first step. And then this P previous link has to be set equal to this address or P new. So, that is the next step. What happens here is first this P news link, this link is set, this link is equivalent to this step, this link is equivalent to this step, that is P news link is set equal to P previous link. P previous link was actually the address of this node, so that is this link. And then what you are doing, this link now you are changing, you have used this already, you are changing this to point to P new, that is this step. So, this link corresponds to this step and this link corresponds to this step. Please note again, you cannot interchange this. If you interchange this, you lose this address. Okay. So, that is very important. Next is adding at the end of the list. We are not again going to do, but here what happens is this is the node where you want to add. Okay. And this is the address of the previous node, but here there is a disadvantage which has not been told here. We are assuming that P3 is available. P3 will not be available. Please note, I already told you that you can access the list only from the head node. So, if you want to find the P previous, you have to keep on searching the list till you find a node whose address link field has address null. Then you know you have come to the end of the list and you note that address as P3, and then what you do? You set the change the link this to point to P new, and then make P new's link equal to null. But this is one disadvantage of representing a list using linked list, because what happens here is that if you want to find the end of the list, assuming that this is only three nodes, so you could found it easily. Suppose you want to insert at the end of the node in a 1000 element list represented using a linked list, you will have to search from right here and go up to the 1000th element before, and find the address of the 1000th element before you can do this addition. So, the addition at the end of the list is not very convenient or efficient if you represent the list in this way. Another way is you can insert after a particular position. Insert a node with data into the list pointed after node. So, you are assuming that you know the address of what he is trying to do is, you want to insert after this, you are given this address, you just insert after this. That is another way of doing this, that is what is told here. And this is where you insert, this is what we have already seen in the previous test, where we insert, you first set this to point to this, and then this was what was initially there. You remove this link, you do not remove this link actually, what you do is this address you know, so set this link to this and make this link into this. So, you have inserted this. This is what we already did, this is just a program for that. So, up to now we have seen creation of an empty list, we have seen addition into an empty list, we have seen addition into the front of a list, we have seen addition into the middle of a list, we have seen addition to the end of a list, and then we have seen addition after a particular node whose address is given. This is fairly straightforward. Now, suppose you had to insert an element in sorted order. Let us assume I have 5, 10, 15, 20, 25 and I wanted to insert 18 in sorted order. Then again I have to traverse from the beginning, find out where that 15 is, store the value and then do insertion in the middle. So, that is also a little bit of a tedious affair as far as insertion into a list using linked list is concerned. Now, let us look at deletion. Again, deletion, you can delete at the first node. Please note here, this is a head node, okay, and this is the list that I have. Now, I want to delete the first node, that is I want to delete 39. Now, what do? I have to make this point to this, that is all, okay. So, what happens is this head, the link, this head now points to this node and the count has to be changed to 2. And this location, that is the node that contained 39, can be recycled or put back into a store of nodes available for insertion. So, this is the deletion. So, actually what happens is when you delete a node, you change the link and there is no link to this node. So, this in other words is also called as dangling reference. This was deletion of the first node. Now, the advantage here was you know the address of the first node which is given by this head. But now, suppose you have a general case of deletion where you want to delete, let us say, this node, then I need the address of this node if I want to delete this node, because what happens, I have to set this, I need the address of this to find out and set this link to point to this. So, again as we did in the case of insertion, what we are doing is we are assuming that we know the address of this very conveniently, but actually to find out this address you have to traverse the list. So, what happens? This is pre, that is the address of the previous node. You have to set the link of this to point to the link of this node. So, this link is made to point to this, because this link was pointing to this. This is the only step for deletion, and this is the recycle node as before, or which is no longer in the picture. So, this is for searching. So, you can search for a target node. So, you have 5, 10, 15, 20, 95, 100. And if you can search for less than the first node, you can search for greater than the last node, and you can search for particular nodes. So, if you search for less than 5, you won't find it. If you search for greater than 5, you won't find it. If the target is between 15 and 20, you won't find it. So, you can search like that. So, this is again deletion, just to make it clear. So, you have the node and you want to delete. So, you want to delete 10, you just delete 10 and put it there. So, if you want to delete the node other than the, now when you are deleting the first node, this is a special case when you are deleting the first node, please note, you, as I told you before, you can insert or you can access an list represented using linked list using only a node, and since this node has now, this node has been removed, you have to set this node to be 50 or the address of this node. Otherwise, you cannot access the node, that is why this has been set to 50. And if you want to delete here 50, you just set this to be here and this has been removed. So, this is the removal of the thing. So, here what you have, a node is equal to next, node not next is equal. So, suppose you want to delete the node after the next. So, you put node of next is equal to node of next, which is this address of next. So, that is this step, and then you free this 50, that is free temp. So, traverse the list, you just go through the list pointing to one after the other until you reach the null. So, after this point, after this function call, the pointer value will be null, because only after you reach null you have reached the end of the list. Sometimes you want to get the first, then you, the pos or the position will point to the first element, and otherwise it will point to the next element, pos of link. So, you can have other list operation like swapping elements, inserting the first element, inserting the last element, deleting before, deleting at the last element, and so on. There are a lot of variations that you can do for insertion deletion also. So, if in order to make you understand this, we have just done a very simple data structure which is list, and we have implemented using arrays and linked list, and I have gone into detail about how to implement it using linked list, because linked list is a concept that we are going to use again and again for representing other type of lists and trees. So this is an example program. Write a program procedure purge that takes the list as argument and eliminates duplicates from the list. So you get just given a list of elements and you are asked to eliminate duplicates. The elements of the list are of type element type. We have not defined what type. It could be integer, it could be a node, it could be anything. So you must write it generally. And a list of such elements has a type list. There is a function same xy, we are assuming a function is available, where x and y are of element type, and is true if an x and y are the same and false if not. So this is for finding out duplicate. Now the same, we have left it as vague. If the element type is real, for example, we might want same xy true if and only if x equal to y. However, if the element type is a record containing the account number, name and address of a subscriber as, then we might want same xy to be true when x dot account number equal to y dot account number. So this x and y or the element type of the list has been specifically left as could be a record, could be a integer, could be a real number and so on. Another problem is you write programs to insert, delete and locate an element on a sorted list using arrays and pointers. Here again, I think I just mentioned to you when we were talking about insertion, that insertion or deletion from a sorted list is not as straightforward as the insertion that we saw. So I am asking you to implement that. And then you can write a program to merge two sorted lists. Again here there is a question, there will be a continuous when you, this is an application that is very clearly where you have a number of insertions and deletions. And please note, when we started we said that if you have a number of insertion and deletion, it is better to use a linked list and then to merge n sorted lists. So this is, if you do these problems, you get a feel of both how to implement a simple list using arrays and linked lists, and also some typical applications that use lists.